Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So for those of you who have been watching for a while, you know that I am not the best at braiding, but I really wanted box braids and I really wanted to do them myself. If you want to see how I did these braids, stay tuned. Now I did have someone else part my hair because as y'all know, it will take me hours to just part something that should only take about 20 minutes. I only use about 1.5 packs of hair. So I'm just going ahead and separating the hair into two pieces and then overlapping it so that I get the desired length that I'm looking for. And I'm going in with my handy dandy edge booster to gel down my roots. I had to skip those first two braids because it literally took me, I kid you not, 30 minutes. But I had to keep redoing the braids because they just weren't coming out right. And I did them too tight for one. It was just a mess, honey. But this time around, I kind of got it together. I started out using the rubber band method first, but sometimes I felt like I did it a little bit too tight. So then as I got closer to the top of my head, I would alternate between doing the rubber band method and then just using my hair as like the third strand and feeding in the rest of the hair as I went. My biggest problem was that whenever I switched the placement of my hand, the direction I would be going in would change. So like if I'm braiding it from the back and then I bring it to the front, that would change the direction of my hand and then the braid would go the opposite way. It was kind of weird, but there were so many times I had to start a braid over because it looked so bad compared to the other ones. And even as I got to the top, I was still having difficulties. And what I realized is there's like a difference in braiding. Like you can braid inward or outward. And I really think I braid both ways depending on how my hands are positioned. And once I try to put it in front of my face so I can see what I'm doing, I end up switching, which is what makes it look super messy. I definitely could have blow dried my hair a little bit straighter, but because I knew I wasn't keeping it in for a while and because I'm a beginner and I felt like I needed some like rough tech, not my hair is rough, but you know, I need some dimension because that hair is so silky. I made sure not to blow it out too straight, and also I didn't want to give myself any heat damage. For me, what I find the easiest is to start the braiding process at the back of my head and to try to keep going at the back of my head for as long as possible. I don't know why, but like feeling it is a lot more different than like looking at it. And usually when I try to bring it to the front, I try to go super slow so that I don't change the direction of my braiding. And if you find yourself, you know, speeding up the process and then it's not looking as good, that means you need to slow it down, girl. As you can see, even though I almost finished with my hair, the process did not get any easier. I was still struggling once I got close to finishing. Honestly, braiding is extremely tiring. Like, I have so much respect for braiders who do people's hair, and even more respect for braiders who do their own hair. And if they do like little tiny little bits of hair, oh my god, I don't think I could ever give myself like little tiny braids. I don't think I could do it. I do not have the patience, and I don't think I have the skill level yet. And even if I did have the skill level, I'm not doing that. I cannot sit through that. It's too much. It's too much.
Y'all, I got 3 braids left, and I think I'm gonna just try to cover it up. I'm tired, and I got work in the morning. I don't know why I do this to myself, but here we are.
I'm tired. I don't know how people do this.
Finally finished.
Once I finished, I did dip the ends in hot water so it sealed them, and then I used some mousse and hairspray so there's a little sheen on my hair because it was looking a little dry. I need to get some luster up in that hair, okay? Of course, we have to get the baby hairs together. No look is complete without a little bit of baby hair. Oh, don't judge me. I'm super blind if you can't tell. All right, guys, and here is the final look. I truly, truly think that it came out pretty good for my first time doing a full head of box braids. Now, granted, it did take me a lot longer than I was expecting it to, but I think the look is there nonetheless. Let me know if you want more tutorials of me trying out new things. I mean, we're in quarantine, so I got all the time in the world. Make sure you thumbs this video up. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and press that notification bell so you're alerted when I post new videos. Thank you guys again, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.